Veterans Day is a federal holiday that is held annually every year on this day, November 11th. This federal holiday is to honor the military veterans who have served in the armed forces. World War I was a global war that took place in Europe and that lasted from July 28, 1914 to November 11, 1918, which was for 4 years and 3 months. World War I ended on this day in 1918, which marks 102 years ago today.
Veterans Day is important to me because my family was in the Air Force and Army. My father was staff sergeant in the Air Force, and my granddaddy was in the Army. My father was stationed in Ohio, Korea, and in Maryland. While I was stationed in Korea, my dad and mom met. A few years later, I was born at Andrews Air Force in Maryland. The military has always been important to me and my family. I love all respect. Respect all the veterans, including my idol, John Cena, who served in the Marines.
Hello, my name is Chad Russo. I'm a teacher here at Mentor High School. And I wanted to take a second to talk about Veterans Day. There's a lot of meanings to Veterans Day, and I think the biggest mistake is some people confuse Memorial Day and Veterans Day. So I wanted to take a quick second just to talk about the difference between the two. So if Veterans Day is a day where we honor all those who served, or Memorial Day is more of a day where we honor the people that gave the ultimate sacrifice and lost their life in combat. Being a veteran, serving in the United States Army from 1993 to 1997, I learned a lot of different things and a lot of different traits. And as a veteran, I try to look at it three different ways. As a teacher, I try to share with my students the importance of being a veteran, the holiday itself, and express the importance of the actual holiday and that it's okay to share your feelings with other veterans. As a parent, I try to identify key characteristics that I learned in the Army, such as honor, respect, teamwork, discipline, tradition, all things that I learned in the Army. I try to carry that over as I teach my children in everyday life. Myself, I look at being a veteran as not only an honor and a day to share with a lot of different people, but it's also a day for me to look back and give thanks for everything that I have, because I know I wouldn't have my career, my wife, my children, my education, if it wasn't for the United States Army. So it's a way for me to say thank you, and it's very proud of being a veteran, and it's a great day to honor all those that have served. In closure today, what I would like to share with my students and the students here at Mentor High School is don't be afraid to go up and say something to a veteran. Speaking as a veteran, there is no better feeling when someone comes up and says thank you for your service or ask you a question about the military, because anytime that I see an opportunity to give back to young students about my experiences or what the Army meant to me and where it got me in life, it's just a great opportunity for me to be able to share things with students and to be able to give back. So please don't hesitate to go up and talk to veterans, ask them questions, ask them about their experiences. It's a great way to honor them and let them know that you do care and that you are appreciative of their service.
Veterans Day, a day where we, the people of America, celebrate the soldiers from the past and the present who fought for us. On November 11, 1919, is when Veterans Day came to life for us to respect and honor those whose lives were lost and those who are still fighting for our freedom today. Veterans Day is all about the wars throughout the ages, big or small, to celebrate those who are still fighting right now and those who are helping us move forward in life for future generations to cherish and prosper in times of peace and tranquility in a horror and war-filled city. It's been a century since the start of Veterans Day. The brave soldiers from before who took up arms and fought for those who wanted to take our land and freedom. Veterans have fought in horrible conditions, and some have lost their lives because of these conditions, and yet they still push through and make sure our land is secure and they return to their loved ones they left behind. Those who couldn't come back from the horrors, here we are in them at ceremony in Washington for their brave and heroic acts. When asked what Veterans Day means to me, well, I like to say, from America and myself, thank you for everything you have done for our future and your service.
I did spend several months and years overseas in conflict, and Veterans Day to me means, you know, respect for those that served. It's not like Memorial Day where you're honoring the dead, it's those that served and that allowed us to do the things that we do for freedom in this country. That allows us the right to vote, to voice our opinion, and to allow us to live the way that we choose to live here.
Veterans Day means a lot to me from all my brothers and sisters that have served in the service, that have given us the ability to do what we want, a place to live, choose where we want to live, choose where we want to eat, choose where we want to sleep, freedom of speech, religion, all those things they have sacrificed to give the younger generation the possibility of doing what they want. It's the American dream. I can't say enough for veterans. I love doing things for veterans. It's the greatest part of my life, is taking care of them, because they took care of us. Thank you so much.
Veterans Day is, to me, is one of the most important days of our holidays of our year. So, I know quite a few people that gave all. So,
I figure it's one of the most important days of the year to remember those that served, not just in all times, in all wars, even in peacetime.
What Veterans Day means to me is it's a day to celebrate and give back to the veterans who have served, the veterans that are alive. A lot of times, you know, people will come up to me and say, Happy Veterans Day and Memorial Day. That's not what that's for. Memorial Day is to remember those who gave the ultimate sacrifice. Today is just a day to say thank you for serving your country and looking out for me.
The military is something that my father served in, my uncles, and things like that, and I'm very proud to do my part to contribute to the betterment of the United States.
It's just a tribute to the service of men and women that have paid the sacrifice to defend the country, and it's a brotherhood, and I'm honored to be a part of it.
Well, Veterans Day is, I believe, the memory of in honor of all the guys that aren't here. It never did come back.
Hello, I am honored to speak here today on such an important topic. Today, we're here to honor all the service members and to remember their sacrifices that they've made and the courage it took them. Today is a day to honor our fellow heroes and remember their achievements, their courage and dedication, and most importantly, to say thank you for all their sacrifices. Thinking of our heroes who are joining us today and those that are only in spirit, a person can't help. We all stand in the midst of patriots and the family and friends of those that have nobly served. All the service members we honor today came from every walk of life, but everyone shared some fundamental qualities. They all possessed courage, pride, determination, selflessness, dedication to the duty and integrity, and all the qualities needed to serve as a cause bigger than to oneself. A majority of them didn't need to ask to leave home to fight on the faraway battlefields. They didn't even volunteer. They didn't love war, having loving fighting. They were called out to war because of being a part of something bigger than themselves. They were just simply ordinary people who responded in extraordinary ways during extreme times. They rose to the nation's call because they wanted a nation protected, which has given them and us a lot. Millions of Americans have fought and died on battlefields, here, everywhere, all abroad, to defend the freedoms and our way of life. Today, our troops continue to make the most ultimate sacrifices, and even as we lose more troops, more Americans step forward and say, "I'm ready to serve." Then they follow the footsteps of many generations of fine Americans. Veterans Day, formerly known as Armistice Day, was originally designated as a day to celebrate the conclusion of World War I, which ended on November 11th of 1918, and the legislation that created Veterans Day, and quoting, "dedicated to the cause of world peace and to be hereafter celebrated," formerly known by Armistice Day. As the years went on, and as we engage in further conflicts during World War II and the Korean War, many veterans groups have lobbied for a change. Rather than honoring the armistice and only those who served in World War I, the nationally recognized holiday would now honor all of our veterans from all wars and conflicts the United States has ever encountered. We've encountered all our troops and their service and sacrifice ever since. Medals have been awarded to many soldiers, their names being added to monuments and buildings being named after them, honoring them for their bravery. But nothing can ever replace the holes left behind by our fallen service members, and no number of medals and ribbons can comfort those left behind. Today, people from all across the country will gather here to remember, honor, and to pay some gratitude to those that have served for our country. This speech here is just one small spark of the flame of pride that just burns across our nation today and every single day. It may not be a lot, but it's just one small way we can honor those who have made the ultimate sacrifice so that we can live in this freedom. This year today, and that the people from all across the country is a tribute to those who lost troops and to their families. This is a way to say that we remember from the soldiers who were shivering and starving through the very freezing cold winter of Valley Forge, to the doughboys crouched in the mud trenches in France, to the platoon who patrolled the hazy jungles in Vietnam, and the young men and women on mountain duty in Afghanistan. We still honor and remember them in all in those ways and more. God bless them and their families. God bless their troops, and God bless America. Thank you very much, and everybody, and I hope you all have a wonderful day. Sincerely, Alex Fish.
The Mentor High School Wall of Freedom honors Mentor High School students who have made the ultimate sacrifice to protect and preserve the American way of life. The students and staff of Mentor High School salute all men and women who have served our nation in times of peace and war. We are forever in their debt. World War II. Harry Alchin. Robert E. Bemis. Andy Booth. Vincent Russell Brown. Edgar Cartwright. Alfred Cole. William Richard Day. Frank Hengesbach. Virginia Jewell. Harry Kohler. Ralph A. Markle. Thomas L. Patterson. Maynard Shanower. Joseph F. Zardin, Jr. Korean War. Alan F. Briggs. Vietnam War. George Ernest Hayward. William Thomas Hurd. Jack William Logan. James Joseph Maynard. Paul Holland Mitchell, Jr. Howard Allen Mucha. Michael Lester Ness. Dean Edward Nicholas. Dale Allen Pierce. Carl A. Progler. Lloyd Andrew Sellers III. Timothy David Stickle. Lloyd Edward Stroich. William Ronald Dickey. Anthony Augustine Shalachi. Iraq War. Joseph W. Lorick. Joshua S. Harmon. Mark T. Schmikowski.
Members, please rise to the attention. Officer today, you will now drape our charter in memory of our beloved comrade, Dale Carnegie.